Good morning and welcome to Unity on the Space Coast. Please rise as you are able to sing our call to worship song, Make Me an Instrument. Mm-hmm. Make me an instrument.
Make me an instrument, Lord of your peace. As I let go, as I release, make me an instrument, humble and free. As I Christ in me, make me an instrument, Lord of your peace. As I let go, as I release, make me an instrument, humble and free. As I awaken the living Christ in me, as I awaken the living Christ in me.
It has been about a year and a half since I made that motion. Yay! Awesome. Let's pray. Dear sweet spirit, we say thank you, thank you, thank you for this day, for this opportunity to come together as a family, to have a reunion, to celebrate one another, to celebrate our spiritual home. We see every one of these beautiful souls, either online or here in the building, we see them all being raised to their highest consciousness this morning. We know that there is only one power in the universe and in our lives, God the good, omnipotent. We give thanks for this in and after the nature of Jesus the Christ, and so it is. Amen. Good morning, good morning, good morning, everyone. Good morning. It's so good to see you. It's good to have you guys all online. I'm Reverend Roxanne Graves. I'm the senior minister here at Unity on the Space Coast. And I am just thrilled that each and every one of you have decided to come and spend the next bit of your time with us. And being that it's a Sunday, and this is my favorite place to be on a Sunday, mm-hmm. I would not want to be anywhere other than right here, right now, with you. So I appreciate you making that possible. I have a couple big announcements for you today. You know, based on the visioning and the mission that we did and our core values, one of the things that came up were that people wanted field trips. Well, Paula Chalfant got right on that, and she's doing a family day at De Leon Springs. How many of you have been to De Leon Springs? I haven't been there in a long, long time, but they got this place where you can eat pancakes, make them at your table, and all that fun stuff. It will be a lovely, lovely day. We have all of the information out on our website. It's July 17th. Everybody's meeting here at the church at 8 a.m. It's a Saturday. Yes, Saturday, July 17th. 8 a.m. meeting right here and carpooling or caravanning over to De Leon Springs. Mm-hmm. Sounds like a blast, doesn't it? I hope each and every one of you can join us. All right, I'd like to introduce Rick Horsey. Yay, come on up. Rick and his wife have come from Texas. They're from the Unity Church in Houston, and Rick has completed all of his seminary classwork, and has the next year as an intern, and he has blessed us with his talents, his time, and his love. So thank you very much. Rick Horsey, ministerial associate intern, you guys will see him a lot. So let's give him a round of applause. Yay! All right, last announcement. I am going on vacation. Ooh. Yay! I will miss you all. I swear I will. But you guys will be so well taken care of. You have Michael Triandafels will be doing the platforming work. Ooh. Yay for Michael. And Rick Horsey will be doing the meditation and the daily word each week. And of course, all of our wonderful singers. Today we have Nick and Mark. Yay. So you guys will be well taken care of. And I know that you will all support them with everything you have. So it's very exciting. Now, I just got in vacation mode. I have to be back here where my feet are. All right. Let's say our vision together. We are the creative I am, dedicating our lives to its full realization through compassion, inclusiveness, and joyous service. And let's say the truth that we know, the prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. Amen. Let's all join in together as we sing our anchor song this month, Imagine.
Please stand as you're able.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us, above us only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. And no religion too. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will live as one. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. Brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. someday you'll join us.
Join us, friends,
and the world.
Thank you. Good morning. Good morning, Unity on the Space Coast. So I'm here for the first day, so that means I want to change things up a little bit because the universe has gifted us with a perfect daily word. And today is our family reunion Sunday celebration. So if you would, let's all begin to relax and go into our meditation mode because these words are so beautiful and so profound. They meant so much to me. Our daily word for today is let go and let God. Our affirmation is, I do what is mine to do and release the rest. And our message, I am equipped with powerful spiritual tools to use toward creating the life of my dreams. Through prayer and meditation, visualization and affirmation, I am willing to work for what I want to see manifest in my life and in the lives of those I care about. Sometimes I can be so focused on what I'm doing that I forget the importance of stepping back from my efforts and releasing my attachment to specific outcomes. There is great peace that comes from knowing I have done all I can do, and then, in perfect peace and clarity, releasing outcomes to the divine that is in all people and circumstances. I heed my guidance to discern when to take action and when to yield to the activity of spirit. Our scripture today is from the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 33. And it reads, strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Now, because this is our family reunion Sunday, I'd like for all of you to bring your family into your hearts and your minds and surround them now with unconditional love. I'd also like to ask you if you have any distance between yourself and anyone in your family, to bring them up into your heart and your mind. Because this daily word speaks to how we can heal those distances and separations. In this moment, it's asking us to let go and let God and let Spirit work within us and from us and through us. Sometimes it says that we become too focused on what we want, too focused on fixing others, too focused on changing others, and we forget to relax into that moment and just be love for the other person. This is what we're always asked to do. If we follow this and we open up our hearts to love, we will be able to bring these people back into our lives and heal these relationships. And in this moment, and in every moment in the future, I want to ask you just to think of one thing to say. Think and ask yourself, how can I bring the most peace to this situation, to this relationship, to this circumstance? Not trying to fix, not trying to be right, but bring the most peace to each and every circumstance that we all find ourselves in. Now, as you come back to the room, slowly stretch and open your eyes. rejoin the world that we're sitting in right now. That feels wonderful. God bless you all. Thank you so much.
That's so special to sit down and do that. Thank you so much, Eric. That was beautiful. What was the name of that piece? Did you just write that? You should name that. It's beautiful. Yeah. Just a few years ago. Good morning. Yay! So glad to see everybody. You know, today my talk is on conflict resolution, because being who I am, when I think of family, when I think of my family of origin, I think about all the work that I've put into it over the last decade or so, maybe a couple, 3 decades, actually. And because of the complexity of family, right? The beauty of family and the complexity of family. And I called it to be right or to be happy. Which decision will you make? That was the title. But for the last few days, the people in Surfside have been really in my heart. They've been in my prayer work. They've been in the forefront of my mind, as I'm sure they have been in all of yours as well. And as I watch things like this, I know that when events happen close to home, that what I hear a lot from family is they wish they could have done it differently. They wish that the last thing that they had said to them would have been something different. And the feeling of that not ever being possible. I've shared that with a lot of people over the years. And I can just see so suddenly, so many people, so much unknown, and knowing that those families of all of those people are going through something they never could possibly have imagined, right? So we hold them. We hold space for them. We hold them in our consciousness. We see God working in their lives every day, every moment. Right? Because that's what we do. That's what's ours to do in this instance. So I'm still going to talk about a little bit about conflict resolution. Actually, that's not really true. What I'm going to do is give you a couple of tips on conflict avoidance, actually. Conflict avoidance. Because we have the power to create our experience. Unity's third principle. You know, I was thinking about what are the funny things that happen. You know, a lot of people say they have difficulty on I-4 when they're driving, somebody cuts them off, and they get mad, right? And then, you know, you have people like me, who I get little things, I act like I'm irritated when somebody does something. Like, for instance, somebody asks me for the millionth time, what color do you use on your hair? And I say for the millionth and one time that I have absolutely no idea. I really wish you quit asking me that in front of everybody. But there you have it. So my question on any of those things like that, those are little things, right? Those are little things. But somehow or another, those little things can trigger us into big feelings. So my tip for you is to release. Debbie says ignore. Release and detach. Let it move by you. If you grab it at first, that's okay. Shake it off. Let it go. And the next time you're asked what color you'd use on your hair, just laugh and go, hey, how was your weekend? And just move past it, right? Because how important is that stuff? Is it worth getting all worked up in that feeling, right? So I had actually put definitely avoid, release, and detach from conflict when it's small or important. Try blessing them instead of engaging. If you find that something really bothered you, and I had this happen to me a couple of days ago, if you find that something's really bothering you and you really don't think it should because it was just somebody going fast on the highway, why should that put me in a bad mood? If you recognize that that's happening, you really don't think it should be, shake it off, put it aside, move on, and then when you have time, get your journal, get some quiet music, get some prayer work done, and start to ask yourself those really hard questions. Like, what is it that I was really upset about? Was it actually the event, or was it something that happened before? This just happened to me a couple of nights ago. I found myself getting really agitated because somebody kept asking me questions and questions and questions. And normally, I'll talk your ear off, right? It's like not a big deal. I'll answer as many questions as you want to ask me. But I was getting irritated because I was thinking about something else, so I wasn't paying any attention. And then when I realized that I was starting to act irritated toward the person asking the questions, I said to myself, what is bothering you about this? And it occurred to me very quickly that I wasn't irritated about the questions at all. I was irritated about a phone call I had had previously and what was unresolved in that phone call. So I was going back over that conversation in my head, and I was getting worked up over that phone conversation. But the person who got it was the person who almost got it. She almost got it, was the one asking me the questions. But I've had a lot of practice, and I can, when I feel myself getting tense, upset, not listening, I know there's something going on, and I can very quickly, I immediately go, what are you afraid of? Because fear is usually the answer for me. I'm afraid, I know I've said this a million times, I'm afraid I'll lose something I have, I won't get something I want, or somebody's going to find out something about me that I'm not going to like. Like what my hair color is. Exactly. Too funny. So learning to recognize what is causing that anger can help tremendously. You know, family reunions. Walk in a building, everybody's there. Do you have that one person that irritates you every time you go to a family reunion? You realize that they're irritating you not because they're irritating you today. They're irritating you because of something that happened a million years back that you never resolved. Try journaling about that. Figure out what it is. See what would have to happen for that to be resolved for you. Allow yourself peace. Allow yourself love. Allow yourself to be free of anger and fear. No one can do that for you, only you. Can I have the next? I want to go over a couple of the Beatitudes, which are in Matthew 5. Jesus, in the Sermon on the Mount, spoke and said pretty much everything he'd ever said in his ministry, he put together in one talk, Sermon on the Mount. One of the Beatitudes is, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Now, does that make it seem like they're sad and unhappy? And that's not it at all. Metaphysically, that isn't it at all. Give me my next one. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Poor in spirit, in metaphysically, means to have emptied yourself of all desire to exercise personal self-will, to have released yourself of the need to win. How many of you know that need to win? Yeah. To relieve yourself, release and empty yourself of the desire to exercise self-will, which to me looks like, yeah, I could take that personally, but you know what? Not that important. You know, that's not really what I did. Not important. I don't have to defend myself. I don't have to be in defense mode, right? Usually when I'm around somebody with high conflict, I can feel the defense. They're ready for the fight. And I know what that feels like and what it looks like because I've done it myself. Being ready for that fight. Poor in spirit, emptying yourself of all desire to exercise personal self-will. That does not mean you don't have personal self-will. That means in that moment in time, you're choosing not to exercise self-will. And what do you get for that? The kingdom of heaven. I don't know. That sounds like a pretty big prize to me for just taking a moment to decide you don't have to win. For just taking a moment to decide that you don't have to correct everybody. What's that that Blake does on the, yeah. Because I've told you before, I suffer from know-it-allism. I practice not saying out loud what I think the right answer is and let other people be creative and lovely and right. The kingdom of heaven. We know that the kingdom of heaven is within. What we get is that connection with God. We already know that if we are angry, frightened, resentful, all of those negative emotions block us from connecting with God. They block us from coming in touch with that godness inside us. So if we can not exercise that personal self-will, we have the opportunity to truly commune with God and experience the kingdom of heaven. And I know these are tips that you don't normally hear. I'm pretty sure that if you were to Google conflict resolution or conflict avoidance, whatever, if you were to Google that, you'd get a lot of very strict business things, you know, step 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and probably none of them would say, release it, detach from it, ignore it, avoid it. If you can step away from an argument, by all means do it. Then bless them and pray for them and give yourself a little bit of atta girl. I managed to get out of that one. And I don't know about your family, but my family, they've got them, man. They've got them. The second tip I wanted to give you, and this one's even funnier, really, surrender and accommodate. I got a couple of funny looks from that one. Surrender and accommodate. Well, wait a minute. Surrendering, that's giving up. Accommodate, what if I just don't like what they have to say? I don't want to accommodate them in that. Well, you have that choice. You absolutely have that choice. But I can tell you that there is no stronger tool in your toolbox than the ability to surrender. If you can master the art of surrendering, you will be one of the most powerful people in the room. Because you, my friend, will have the choice of the experience that you're having. If you can surrender, I learned that in a business event I think I've told most of you, but I'm going to share it very quickly. All the big bosses were gone. They were all on this trip. So I was in charge. It was kind of like, you know, yeah. Everybody except the secretary, you know, whatever. So I'm there, and I'm in charge, and this big thing happens, and somebody comes and visits and says, you have to do this, 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 this. And I said, awesome, let's do it. And I got the whole place working. We got it done, mailed out. And I'm thinking, when they get back, they are going to be so grateful. That did not happen. When they got back, my boss calls me into his office, and I'm thinking, this is it. This is where I get my raise, maybe even a promotion. And he was mortified. You had absolutely no business doing any of that. It was not your place. No one gave you permission to do that. And I was like going, oh my goodness, oh my goodness. You ever have that feeling where your head's kind of swimming around going, is this really happening? Pretty surreal. But I had been studying Sermon on the Mount. And I think it had just been a week or two earlier that we talked about the idea of being meek. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. We had just been talking about that. And so as I'm listening to him tell me all the reasons that was completely wrong, it occurred to me, in reality, everything he's saying is correct. I didn't have permission to do it. It really wasn't my place. It should have been an executive in some position elsewhere to do that. Not my thing to do. And so I just looked at him when he took a breath. I let him take a breath. And then I told him, you're exactly correct. I should never have done that without permission. And it shut him up immediately. Because he didn't have anything else to say. When Roxanne, under normal circumstances, would have started explaining to him why it was a good idea, I would have been explaining to him to try to convince him that I was right, that I had done it for good reason, and that if he just listened to me, he'd understand that. But instead, I had that moment of saying, yeah, you're the boss. You're right. And then he just sent me back to my office. And I was like, wow, did that really happen? Do I not have to argue and explain myself constantly? Because at the time, I was one of those people that would break the printer before asking how to use it. Can this really be that simple? So I continued to test it. I continued to surrender. And I walked around one of the happiest people I knew. I actually still walk around one of the happiest people I know. Because surrender, when it's your choice to do so, is a miraculous tool. But if it's not the right tool, it's not a good thing to do. And you'll know that when, you know, I absolutely cannot surrender this. And these are the reasons why. And you're not telling this person that. You're telling yourself that. Because there's something, for any reason that you say, I just can't do that. You definitely don't want to surrender because then you put yourself in a victim space, right? And you walk around mad that you even let it go. The idea of surrendering is to gain the power of your experience. Blessed are the meek. And I do not have my book. Would you run to my office and grab Sermon on the Mount? Thank you. Thank you, Lily. Because I want to read you a definition of the word meek that was given to us from Emmett Fox. It has to be read, in my opinion. It has to be read because it's just magnificent. But I'll tell you about the earth in the meantime. If you can be meek, then what you do is inherit the earth. And the earth is your outer experience. The earth is what's happening out here right now. And if we inherit that, we get dominion over it, which means we have power and control. Bless you. Thank you. We have dominion. We can make the choices of what we experience here. If we can be meek. So I want to read you this definition of the word meek. Because, you know, when you think of somebody meek, you think they're shy and quiet and maybe even a little bit of a doormat, you know, that kind of thing. But that's not what this means. That's not metaphysically the word meek. The true significance of the word meek in the Bible is a mental attitude for which there's no other single word available. It is a combination of open-mindedness, faith in God, and the realization that the will of God for us is always something joyous and interesting and vital and much better than anything that we could think of for ourselves. This state of mind also includes the perfect willingness to allow this will of God to come about in whatever way divine wisdom considers to be the best, rather than in some particular way that we've chosen for ourselves. It comes about when we allow spirit to work in our lives, when we step into the flow of our lives and not have that preconceived idea of how everything should work out. Or even if we had it, not to get attached to the outcome, not to get attached and say that it has to look like what I think it needs to look like. So being meek is, for me, and I'm only going to say this for me, being meek is I'm not bulldozing my way through everybody's space. I am not the one that has to be in charge of everything. I'm not the one that has to tell you the way that it goes. Now, those of you that work with me might have a different opinion. I don't know, but I try hard. Okay. And, you know, if we can do these lovely things, if we can be poor in spirit and release all of our preconceived ideas, allow God to work in our lives, gain control of our outer experience, and be able to connect to God on a regular basis, I would hope, actually I would know, that this would leave each and every one of you in a place of no regret. So I want to end with this scripture. It's Romans 12, 9 through 21. It's like the perfect instructions of who and how to be. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in love. Outdo one another in showing honor. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with those who are in need and extend hospitality to strangers. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud, but be willing to associate with people of low position. Do not claim to be wiser than you are, Roxanne Graves. All right. Do not repay anyone evil for evil. Be careful to do what is right in the eyes of everyone. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Do not take revenge. Amen. So, I want you to think about all of that this week. You know, I watch you guys do all of those things with one another. That's how you do treat one another, and I love that. That's how you treated me the first time I ever came here. With joy and love and kindness. I just saw the metaphysical definition of meek, or for earth, I'm sorry, inherit the earth, right? I'm talking about having dominion. It says the power to bring your conditions of life into harmony and true success. Wow. Your conditions of life into harmony and true success. I think those two beatitudes pretty much take care of my character defects. So, I love you all very much. Talk to you later.
Okay. You really moved me. Don't tempt me. These are definitely words to live by. So listen to the lyrics. And at the chorus, please sing along with us.
Some of you will know this song.
You can certainly dance if you want to.
I like to picture the girl through a looking glass. See her as a carbon atom. See your eyes and stare back at them. See that girl as her own little world. Though her home is on the surface, she is still the universe.
Glory God, oh God is peeking through the blinds. Are we all here standing naked, taking guesses at the actual date and time? Oh my, justifying reasons why is an absolutely insane resolution to live by. Live high.
Come on, sing it. Here we go.
Live mighty. Live righteously. Taking it easy, living high. Live mighty. Live righteously.
I like to picture the man to always have an open hand. See him as a giving tree and see him as matter. Matter of fact, he's not a beast, no. No, not the devil either. Always a good deed doer.
And it's laughter that we're making after all. The call of the wild is still an ordination wide. In the order of the primates, all the politics are too late. Oh my, the congregation in my mind. This is assembly singing of gratitude, and we're practicing good loving for you. Live high,
come on,
and mighty. Live righteously.
Come on, here we go.
Taking it easy, living high. And mighty,
whoa,
live righteously.
Come on, Nick.
And sing it out and just take it easy. And celebrate the malleable reality. You see, nothing is ever as it seems.
and this life is but a dream.
Go on, here we go.
Lifting up to the Almighty. Raise your hands and start acknowledging. Taking it easy, living high and mighty, live righteously. Taking it easy, living high and mighty, live righteously. Taking it easy, live high.
Come on, let me hear you.
And mighty. Righteously, I say we're just taking it easy.
Thank you.
Give yourselves a round of
applause. That's beautiful singing. Thank you.
That's what I was trying to say.
That's what I was thinking when you were receiving your message. I'm like, good.
Clairol number five.
Oops.
I love it. Now's the time in our service where we celebrate our prosperity with our gifts, our tithes, and our love offerings. If you're in the building, we have a basket for the tithes. If you're online, you can donate on our website, on a Facebook page, through Tithely, through Venmo. You can even send us a check. We can still take it to the bank. Surely. All right. Hold those tithes either in your mind, your heart. Hold them together physically if you have them. And let's say our blessing together. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. Thank you, God, for the joy of living and receiving. And so it is. Sorry. I want to put a final blessing on the offering. Mother, Father, God, we know that this offering is the very substance of your being, created for us before the world was even formed. We know, acknowledge, and affirm that according to your perfect law, it returns to each giver heaped up, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. And for an increased understanding of this law, we do give thanks. And so it is. Amen.
Although I speak with tongues of men and of angels, and though I prophesy and understand all, and though I have all faith so mountains may be removed, and though I feed the poor and give up my life, if I have not charity, if love does not flow from me, I am nothing. Spirit, reduce me to love. Love is patient and kind. Love is not envious, not proud, but gentle and meek. Seeks not its own way. Love sings and always prevails, believes and endures all things. Love hopes and bears every wrong, and love never fails. If I have not charity, if love does not flow from me, I am nothing. Spirit, reduce me to love. One season I was a child. I thought and I spoke as a child. But when I turned to a man, such ways put aside. Though now we see through a glass, oh, then we shall see face to face. Though now abide faith and hope, the greatest is love. If I have not charity, if love does not flow from me, I am nothing. Not charity, if love does not flow from me, I am
here for the first time today? I do not think so. Oh, I'm sorry. Well, see, I heard about you the other day, and I met you already this morning, so to me, you're like family already. Come on in. You have to walk along this way so the people at home get to see that there's pizza coming in.
Oh, pizza.
All the way
pizza.
Straight through those doors.
Pizza, pizza.
Yay. So right after service, we're having a pizza and salad family reunion party. So everybody here, please stay. If you're watching from home, it can come. Please do. There's some lovely salads have been brought, and there's the pizza. That was awesome. The only thing that would have made that any better was if he'd have come while we were doing the offering, right? while we were being grateful for our prosperity, in comes the pizza. Yeah, that's awesome. Awesome. Ah. So we have a newcomer packet for you, and we would love to give you a free book as a gift from us. Our bookstore manager, if you stand up a minute, Michelle. she can help you with that. And I hope you stay and have some pizza and some salad and let these folks love you up, because they will. They're wonderful about that. And if you'd like information about our ministry and you are online, either send me a message through Facebook, our website, call the church, because I'll answer. And I'll be happy to either talk to you about our ministry or send you information about Unity Movement and Unity on the Space Coast. If you'd like to have a prayer request, also the same ways, you can contact us all of those ways. We have prayer chaplains that would love to pray with you, either one-on-one or just in their daily prayer work. You can also leave a prayer request in the prayer box in the back of the sanctuary, and you'll go on the prayer list. Then we send it to Unity headquarters in Missouri, and they pray for them for 30 days or around the clock, 24 hours a day. So lots of good, strong prayer work goes behind those. Don't be shy. Of course, our family reunion pizza thing. What else we got? Oh, Charlie. Oh, my goodness. Next weekend is a big weekend. It starts Saturday night, 6:30. Charlie's got a concert. Then on Sunday morning, he is actually doing the special music and the message. And then right after service, we're going to have hot dogs and chips to celebrate the 4th of July. I believe your board is putting that together for you. And then right after that, Charlie has a workshop on the heart of A Course in Miracles. Hmm. And I know there are lots of people that are interested in A Course in Miracles. So, Charlie, Saturday night, Sunday morning, Sunday midday, Sunday afternoon. We'll feed you, we'll keep you company, we'll love on you. All right. Then on the 11th, we have Kimbaloo coming. I told you, you'll be so well taken care of while I'm on vacation, it'll be crazy. Kimbaloo's coming in on the 11th of July. We love, love, love her, and she's also giving the message and doing the special music. And then on the 18th, it's my friend Don Barton. He's been here a couple of times. Tall, white hair, very handsome. He's a dear friend of mine. He just was ordained 2 weeks ago. So we're very excited about that. And he's going to do, "This is God, so act accordingly," is his talk. Don't forget that we have spiritual enrichment and education coming up on the 19th to the 23rd of July. If you're interested at all, contact me or just go out on our website and register. Metaphysical discussion every Tuesday and Thursday at 1 p.m., led by Dixie Reedy. And it's just, you know, something you don't understand, something that doesn't sound right to you. I know that most people have those things in the Bible that's like, "I don't like the Bible because it says this." Well, bring that in. Let us metaphysically interpret that and share together what that means for each and every one of us. So, then let's stand and sing our song of peace. Mm-hmm.
On earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, a peace that was meant to be, with God as creator. Family all are we. Let us walk with our family in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now,
right now.
With every step I take, let this be my joyous vow, to take each moment and live each moment. Let there be peace on earth,
and let it begin with me.
Say our affirmation for the day together. I do what is mine to do and release the rest. Have a wonderful week. I love you. Mwah.
You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, friends, and the world will be as one.
Have a wonderful week and see you next Sunday.